Ghost Trick Machines, what an extravaganza weekend. Let's dig on into this, shall we? Don't be like the 37.6% of you that have not smashed all the crap out of that subscribe button so we can get to 100K. So I wanted to just do a little recap here on some of the events here, and we'll talk about the extravaganza deck list out of New Zealand for this weekend. So I've kind of noticed, while the format has still been very top-heavy with what we've seen as the norm at this point in time, there's been a little bit of a shift in the meta in regards for Tier 2 kind of returning back to play. And so I wanted to mention Eldritch here, because out of all of the our Remote Duel Invitational qualifiers this weekend, which I'll cover today at 11, I have a lot of lists for you guys there, Eldritch was a pretty big factor in the top 8s across the board from a lot of players I saw that either played against them or had the chance to experience Eldritch with their own hands. So that's actually kind of interesting. I also wanted to put a mention here to Phantom Knights, because it would seem that the New Zealand meta, according to a couple people I talked to, were talking about the Phantom Knights have kind of been on a rise in their metagame. Now, I've talked about Phantom Knights a little bit in the past. This deck's got some pretty cool plays. I even as far as went to make a video a long time ago going, why is this deck not seeing more play? Because technically, the deck's combo ceiling, anything like an F-Zero and Apollosa, you know, Rusty Tin Can in the back, and all the other stuff that it's already been kind of set up to do. I mean, you're really only losing to what? Dark Ruler No More, technically? And half the metagame doesn't even care about playing Dark Ruler No More, so there's not really much of a point that you really need to worry about there for contention. So if your opponents don't know what your deck does, or they can't really adjust to handle your metagame presence there, then you should be dominating about 95% of the time. So to see a nice little push back here from Phantom Knights adapting more towards the meta, I think is very good. I also wanted to throw in a point here for Crossout Designator. Crossout is on the horizon here, ladies and gentlemen. You're about, what, 3 weeks from legality? All right, maybe two, depends. I don't remember off the top of my head. I just wanted to throw in a mention here for Crossout Designator. Whether or not the card impacts the meta on a severely crazy level or whatnot, because the meta is inherently as diverse as it is, you will see a shift in hand trap momentum based on this card coming into the format between one-ofs and whatnot. Now remember, as I said, not every deck is going to play this. Decks like Eldritch will probably take a back seat with this card because they already care about playing the trap board as it is. Eldritch doesn't really care about getting hand trapped versus an Ash Blossom against Eldritch's. What do they care about? They care about playing the Barrow? No. So Crossout Designator for some other rogue decks will not really impact them whatsoever. But where I'm sitting right now, Crossout Designator will be the next major change that we see in the metagame. So there's that. Alright, let's pass it on over for Spooky Machines and some other cool stuff, shall we? Alright, the first list we have out of the extravaganzas in New Zealand was Gareth M's Spooky Machines. I absolutely love this. So we're playing a Ghost Trick Engine with Orcust. Yeah, you wanna sub-reason as to why Mary's went up before we got the new support? Well, really, here you are, I guess. So by the one copy Mr. Jack Frost. Okay. Two copies of Jingaishi, which is our searcher, two copies of Lantern, which is going to be an attack stopper, and two copies of Mary, which is going to be a special summon extender via damage. And then we have one copy Spectre, which ends up being a draw one. What in the world is this? Then we have three standard Mech Grisu for dumping, the one Gizmekarochi, the one Bombard, because, you know, other good cards are banned, two Symbol Skeleton, two Orcus Nightmare, and the one copy of the World One. Then we have Triple Book, then we have two Mansion here. So monsters can not attack face down defense position monsters, but can attack directly if all monsters or opponent controls are face down defense position. Alright, and then all effect battle and damage inflicted by monsters other than Ghost Trick monsters have. So basically just activate this, laugh at your opponent, which it's kind of interesting. Then we play the one Parade. Monsters cannot attack face-down defense position monsters, but they can attack directly if all monsters the opponent controls are face-down defense position. Your opponent takes no damage. Okay, and then when a monster declares an attack and add one Ghost Trick monster from your deck to your hand, this ends up being a Rota. This downside is this ends up being our Continuous Searcher, but the opponent's not taking damage for this. So it's like your one major trade-off with this. And then, of course, I assume this was our major win con here, the Triple Mystic Mine. We have the one Babel, two Return, one Terraforming, one Upstart, the one Renovation. Now, This is actually interesting, and you guys need to be aware of this. So you can target one ghost trick field spell in your field zone, return it to your hand, all right? And then you can activate one spell card from your hand or deck, all right? All right, so you activate Mystic Mine from your deck. All right, it's basically just a better metaverse. And then you can banish this card from your graveyard, target a ghost trick exceed monster you control, special summon from your extra deck, one ghost trick exceed monster with a different name by using the target as material, and of course it'll transfer. It helps set up for the win con down here with Angel of Mischief. We have one Scare, the one Vanish, the triple Imperm, and the two Crescendo, with the one Underworld Goddess, the one Unicorn, the one Phoenix, triple Galtea, Access Code Talker, one Cursed Javelin, one Break Sword, Dullahan with Mischief, Alucard, Zeus, and two Dingrisu. Then we have triple Ghost Spell, triple Nibiru, triple Cosmic, triple Dark World No More with one Harvey Southerduster, and the two evenly matched here. Wrapping up Gareth M's second place list. What an interesting deck. Now, winning that particular event was Virtual World. Now, there's nothing particularly, like, too crazy about this. It really stands out to me, at least in the main deck here, for Tomas's list here. The one Veiler, which was weird. We're playing Desires, which I think is probably your best turbo option here. I do like the two Chuchi ones, Wanwu. We've definitely, I know in the earlier days, like, we were seeing three Chuchi with the one Wanwu, which I think is fine. I also see down here that we are playing Kaliga with the Muddy Mud Dragon package, so you'll be ending on that Crystal Wing Kaliga. Really no fun allowed on the opponent. Outside of that, this is pretty standardized for VW, still even to this day. Now, out of another remote dual qualifier event here, we have Keza D's. Interesting synchro list here. Now, this synchro list is actually taking advantage of the Ascantor Dawnwalker. So you can discard one card, special summon this card from your hand in defense position, then you can special summon one Fire Ant over here, which ends up being another tuner, alright, from your hand or deck. You can special summon monsters from the extra deck to turn your activated effect, except for synchro monsters, which is fine because we're going to be synchro summoning the entire time anyway here. So basically the entire functionality of this deck is you're going to climb up and you're start setting up synchro plays here. Thank Mr. Junkspeeder for being an absurd card here, allowing you the chance to actually capitalize with this. And this is actually playing Baby Mud Dragon. If this card you control uses synchro material, you could treat it as a non-tuner. If this card sends the grave a synchro material, you can declare one type or attribute. That target synchro monster becomes the declared type and attribute till the end of this turn. So talk about extending capability options here, setting up for these additional extra board breaks for you to do your thing with. Feels really good. Down here, the extra deck feels very standard to me. There's nothing like particularly interesting or crazy here. I just kind of wish it'd be awesome to see more of the variants that would like produce like the Stardust, the bigger monsters to like bully the opponent. But I do like what this build is trying to do. 46 cards, by the way. Some people out there might be a little bit put off by that, but I think this works out perfectly. Next up, we have Connor S's. Yes, we are playing Zodiac Eldritch. Now, it's been a little while since we have seen a deck like this, and this was the winning event, by the way, taking out the Synchro deck here. We originally saw Zulich at the, before it got bullied out of the format with Drydent running around. The deck's main purpose was to capitalize on Zeus, you know, hide behind like a Drydent or something, and Zeus would be a follow-up play. Well, this deck actually is taking advantage of its trap board here, and then you go first, you Eldritch your opponent. You go second, okay, so you can set up any of your multiple one-card exceed monsters. Zeus your opponent, then you can go ahead and set up your entire trap board here. The other thing of particular interest here that I find interesting is the inclusion of Mind Crush here. Any sort of like variation or your opponent would have, I don't know, search anything from the deck, VW does it. Really anything that just interacts with the deck and gets that searchable piece that they need, you just mind crush it out of their hand, and you're literally good to go. I know a lot of people were kind of upset with this card post-ruling change, but I still think that this works out for this deck. There should be no reason, still not to consider this. So, we're also playing Triple Huge Revolution is over down here in the side deck. Oh my god, holy negation. Alright, so there's that. Now, there's another event here. There were three little qualifiers for the extravaganzas here. The other one was another Zombie Lich here. Now, instead of playing, you know, the Zodiac package here, we're going to the zombie side of things here. So we're going to take advantage of Boulder Drock here and more of the Unizombie package for discarding and setting up for your generic plays here. And as you see, this one aims on everybody's favorite Zombie World Rivalry luck. All right. If you say you don't like Floodgates, I understand that, but man, oh man, being able to not let your opponent play the game because you just rivalry Zombie World lock them is one of the most hilarious feelings in the game of modern Yu-Gi-Oh! So, why not take advantage of it? Alright, it feels real good. I also like how Guardian is starting to see a little bit more play now as a one-of. Especially like, how Guero doesn't have as much usability as he used to. So, I don't know, I'm just kind of finding Guardian to be a little bit more usable at this point in time. And the last list I have for you guys here is another, here's Mr. Phantom Knight. Taylor McNeil's first place list here. As you can see, we are packing in 45 cards. Which is fine. This build is playing an assortment of, like, I would say more hand traps to kind of counter down the specific of the meta here, especially like the crows here. Double Levyers, we can set up Utopic Future. Yeah. And then we have the OTK package in here. Hello, Mr. Ark Rebellion himself. So, what do you guys think about the list from this event? Please, guys, leave a comment down below. Tell me what you guys think. Smash the little crib on that subscribe button so you guys don't miss out on more awesome content. And I will see your beautiful faces back here later on the day with some more cool awesome content. Peace out, guys. Have a good one. Thank you, patrons, for making the ride never truly end. Without you guys' support, well, I would probably be doing Truffle Shuffle videos for a living. Guys, please check out Vanguard 40 for all of your Cardway Vanguard content brought to you by Vanguard 40. And if you are looking to pick up singles, check out mcolgames.com for your trading card game needs. Thanks for watching, everybody.